Hello, 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 everybody. Today is a beautiful Saturday morning, and we are hopping around to a few different Cars and Coffee events. But in the meantime, this video is going to answer one of the questions that I get the absolute most, and that is, how much did Mike Ducati cost me? I wanted to make this video honestly because I feel like there's a lot of missing transparency when I purchased my first Ducati motorcycle. So I wanted to go through this experience with you all. I think it's important to go into this video with the knowledge that on Ducati's website, the Panigale V2 is listed at $16,495, but my final cost was $27,409. That's a difference of $10,914. When I was contemplating buying a V2, Ducati North America was running a 0% finance deal that sounded too good to be true, and guess what? It definitely was. Every model except the Panigale V2 and the Street Fighter V4 were available for this offer. So the transaction definitely made my bank account hurt. Before we jump into the cost breakdown, I'm going to ask you all to take a moment to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate your support as I churn out new content week after week. Alright, let's go to the top. So, the MSRP of the bike is $16,495. The MSRP is the manufacturer's suggested retail price, also known as the sticker price. Since this was the first Panigale V2 at the dealership, there's no haggling to drop that price down. If you were to look at buying a V2 next year or the year after, you might have a little more wiggle room than what I had. When I was considering the Panigale V2, I test rode one with every piece of carbon that you could get from the Ducati. But honestly, what really stood out to me was the sound of the complete titanium exhaust system from Akrapovic. I did not know how much it cost when I was test riding the bike, but I knew I needed it if I was going to purchase the V2. It just sounds so good. Well, little did I know that this little piece cost $5,400, and that did not include installation. So, I added the complete titanium exhaust system to my Panigale V2 and used a special discount for my dealer, so it dropped the $5,400 price to $4,590. But there was an additional $1,410 installation cost that was added back on. So the total price for the Akrapovic system was $6,000. There was a bunch of other hidden fees that were not really made apparent until the final paperwork was given to me. The freight cost was $655, the dealer prep fee was $541, and I want to pause on that because when I picked up my bike, it was still dirty. But back to the cost. There was a title registration fee of $16 and a temporary license registration fee of $1. Now, I elected to get some additional insurance with my motorcycle. The first one was wheel and tire protection for $1,350. Yeah, that was a really tough pill to swallow, but I did it because Michigan is notorious for having terrible roads and potholes the size of humans. While the Pirelli Rosa Corsa 3s are all around are about $150 for each tire, the rims on the bike are closer to $2,500. So heaven forbid I hit a pothole big enough to dent my rim, I come out financially on top. I've had the bike for a few months now and I've already found a nail in my tire. Brought the bike back into the dealer and a day later I was riding out with a brand new tire. While it's expensive, I'd recommend it. Next up, I elected to add gap insurance for $790 to my purchase. The guaranteed asset protection or gap insurance basically helps cover the difference in the value of my motorcycle at the time it's totaled and the balance owed on the loan or the lease of the bike. So since I take a drastic hit of the price of the bike the moment I leave the dealership, I'm already underwater. What this insurance does is it covers me so I don't owe the bank anything if the bike is, you know, heaven forbid, totaled. And of course, we can't forget to pay our sales tax to Uncle Sam. Michigan's sales tax rate is currently 4%. The county sales tax that I live in is 1%, and the Birmingham sales tax is 4%. So altogether, that's 9% of the $16,495 MSRP, which equals $1,316. And of course, we're not done yet. To add a few more items to the docket, there is a $45 title and registration fee and a $200 document administration fee. So let's go through this and add it up, right? $16,495 MSRP. $6,000 for added accessories and labor, $650 freight, $541 dealer prep, $16 title fee, $1 temp registration fee, $1,350 wheel and tire insurance, $790 gap insurance, $1,316 worth of sales tax, a $45 title fee, and a $200 document administration fee, for a grand whopping $27,409. This is a big number, and I wish there was more transparency in setting the expectations of that before I walked into my dealership with my gear waiting to ride my brand new Panigale V2. But that's why I wanted to create this video. I love Ducati, the brand, and I absolutely love my Panigale V2. But over time, I think of its price, and it honestly scares me. There's a lot of things that I could have done with that money, but you know what they say, right? You can't take money to the grave, so enjoy what you can at the moment. And honestly, I make this video not to scare you or not to discourage you from buying a Ducati. I encourage you to do so, but I wanted you to have a little more insight into like what all the fees are that go into buying a new motorcycle, especially with the Ducati, which is already at, you know, the topper levels of motorcycle purchase prices, what to expect. Am I happy that I bought my Ducati? Absolutely. I love this bike. And every time I ride this bike, I'm reminded why I bought it and why I love it even more. Would I have bought this bike if I knew that the grand total would be about 27 grand? Maybe not. You know, there are a lot of other bikes that I could potentially have bought for this price. Hell, there are multiple bikes that I could have bought for this price if I knew going into it what exactly I'd be getting into, right? KTM 690 Supermoto and a KTM 690 Enduro, boom, both of those bikes together equals the same as this. That's a hard bargain to beat. Like, that's the ultimate two-car garage or two-bike garage in my mind. Anyway, guys, this video is coming to an end. I'm really curious on how much you guys spent for your V2s if you bought them. Let me know in the comments below. I know that this video is going to get a lot of comments, so I look forward to it. Let's keep it going. All right, guys, thanks for everything. If you haven't already, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and go out there and ride safe.